got at the plate?
I think a little bit of confidence built off of last night, with the fact they were able to come out of the gates there for the first three runs. I think it carried over in tonight, but a lot of two-strike pitches spoiled by our guys. And some of them were with good swings. Some guys put the ball in play, and then other guys, almost kind of looked like a desperation swing, but it was whatever it took with two strikes. So that complemented with confidence, I think, was something we had going.
What did you like from Zach tonight?
I thought it was the best game he pitched at University of Tennessee, and I think his best baseball is ahead of him. I mentioned to someone in the media that it's going to be frustrating in about 5 years. He's going to be pitching on a whole nother level. So he keeps getting better and better, and I just hope we get to experience some more like that while he's here.
What do you think's changed in his game?
No question, development of off-speed pitches, but there's a lot of kind of the game within the game type things that have gone on. He's gotten much more mature with his routine in between outings. To be honest with you, when he took his shirt off the other day, I was kind of surprised. I mean, he's pretty ripped up right now, and he was a lot of baby fat when we first got here. So not that I'm walking around judging our guys and trying to see who can be the next J. Crew model or anything, but that's why I kind of hesitate to explain myself. But, you know, he wasn't in the best of shape in a lot of different ways when we first got here. And, again, it's another guy that is a testament to Coach Q. But also Coach Anderson's really got him turned into more of a pitcher as opposed to just a country thrower.
How tough is it to throw 13 strikeouts in a game?
Very, very difficult, especially when you've been told three different start times to a game, and then you start throwing, and we tell you shouldn't have started throwing yet. It was just kind of a mess before the game, and Coach Mercer from Indiana was real good with us to kind of work through it, and I'm just glad we got to play. I mean, win or lose this early in the year, we just want innings for our guys, and you play a doubleheader, you run the risk of losing some of those innings, so it was good we got out there and played nine today.
Indiana made a couple early fielding mistakes there in second. How big was it for y'all to capitalize and get two early runs in the lead?
Any time someone makes a mistake, it's key for you to capitalize on it. That's what good teams do. It's kind of like a tennis player. You know, if the other player makes more unforced errors, you're probably in a pretty good position to win that game. So obviously we want to limit those things on our end, but you got to have a little mojo to take advantage of other teams' mistakes. And I think our guys have that. I don't mind mentioning it. I don't think it's going to go away. I hope it gets better and stronger through tough times. But they like being around each other, and it's interesting to see how much they're cheering for the other guys. Because there's some guys that are getting slided right now on at-bats and innings, and we're also mixing in a lot of guys. So I think they're happy for each other when they do well.
What can you say about this start that you're having? 6-0 now, first time since 2014. Now, that's tough to do no matter who you play, and y'all are really blowing people out as well.
Well, I think what we're doing is, right now getting a little bit of a reward from the work that was put in January and February. It was a really unique time with the construction we had going on our field, but also in the locker room. And sometimes that stuff can bring you a little closer together. And then also it forced us to use all kinds of different sites to practice, and we're working at all kinds of strange hours. So I think it's brought the guys close together to come out of the gates in strong fashion. But, also we've been fortunate enough to play at home. We've caught some breaks. We've played in some close ones too. So we've just had some good things going for us. And, we've delivered some punches, but in the SEC especially, you better be able to take some punches too. And when that does happen, we'll find out what our guys can do.
Definitely good bats, but what can you say about the strikeouts, an unreal amount of strikeouts in these first six games? What's the secret there?
Well, Coach Anderson's pretty good at what he does, and he's done a phenomenal job with those guys. And, he's had an ample amount of time to work with a lot of them, including the freshmen, because he was able to forge a relationship with them in the recruiting process. But also, you're looking at two catchers that are pretty dang good. And I don't know, Pav struggled with Wallace a little bit tonight because Wallace's ball was moving almost like a wiffle ball plus velocity. But those two catchers are pretty dang good at what they do, and that makes for a quality battery regardless of which one we use.
You mentioned that it was nice to just get out there and play today. If it weren't for that new surface out there, what would today have been like?
It would have been a wash. We would have came and hit in the cages, and then we would have just banged it and played two tomorrow. And that might have meant two seven-inning games. It might have meant playing real early in the morning, which they don't want to do, we don't want to do. And if we played 14 innings instead of 18, maybe you don't get a Camden Sewell and a Chase Silseth out there that are freshmen that need experience, but they're also pretty good freshmen. So we need to get them repetitions to find out they may be better than an older guy, you know, in the seventh inning against the first place SEC team or whatever situation it might be.
A couple weeks ago, you mentioned that you thought the pitching staff would be the strength of the team. Did you picture them being this dominant early on?
No, but I like when I sound smart because it's rare. But no, it was something that, you know, kind of showed us in the fall that it was going to be one of our strengths and kind of the core of the team is some of those returning pitchers. And I think they've helped kind of almost a big brother program bring along some of those freshmen or younger guys along with Coach Anderson. So it's our strength, but also if you look at any good team, at 90% of the time in baseball, the pitching staff is a strong point, and then the offense can only make it better. There's always a couple, two, three college teams that can really slug it out with anybody in the country, but otherwise, especially in professional baseball, a good team usually means good pitching. Thanks, guys.